Hello students, I am Swati Kirangi, IICMR MCE. Today we will see team development in organization behavior. The process of learning to work together effectively is known as team development. Research has shown that teams go through definitive stages during the development. A team cannot be expected to perform well right from the time it is formed. Forming a team is just like maintaining a relationship. It takes time, patience, requires supports, effort, and members often go through recognizable stages as they change from being a collection of strangers to a united group. Tuckman has presented a model of 5 stages: forming, storming, norming, performing, and adjoining. In 1965, a psychologist named Bruce Tuckman said that teams go through 4 stages of development: forming, storming, norming, performing. Later, in 1977, he introduced one more stage, that is adjoining. The stages start from the time that a group just meets until the project ends. Each stage plays a vital part in building high-functioning team. First stage is forming. It takes place when the team first meet each other. In this first meeting, team members introduce each other. They share information about their backgrounds, interests, experience, and form first impressions of each other. They learn about the project they will be working on, discuss the project objectives, and start to think about their role. They are not yet started working on the project. They are effectively filling each other out and finding their way around how they might work together. During this initial stage of team growth, it is important for team leader to be very clear about team goals and provide clear direction regarding the project. The team is dependent on team leader to guide them. Second stage is storming. As the team begins to work together, they move into storming stage. This stage is not avoidable. Every team, most especially a new team who has never worked together before, goes through this part of developing as a team. In this stage, the team members compete with each other for status and for acceptance of their ideas. They have different opinions on what should be done and how it is to be done, which causes conflict within the team. As they progress through this stage, with the guidance of team leader, they learn how to solve problems together, function both independently and together as a team, and settle into their roles and responsibilities in this team. For team members who do not like conflict, this is a difficult stage to go through. The team leader needs to be adept at facilitating the team through this stage. This stage will come to closure when team becomes more accepting of each other and learns how to work together. At this point, the team leader should start transitioning some decision making to the team to allow them more independence, but still stay involved to resolve any conflict. Usually, teams comprised of members who are professionally immature will have a difficult time getting passed through this stage. Next stage is norming. When team moves into norming stage, they are beginning to work more effectively as a team. In this stage, the team has agreed on their team rules for working together, how they will share and resolve team conflict, and what tools and processes they will use to get their job done. The team members begin to trust each other and actively seek each other out for assistance and input. The team members also start to make significant progress on the project. In this stage, the team leader may not be as involved in decision making and problem as before. The team has greater self-direction and is able to resolve issues and conflict as a group. The team leader should always ensure that the team members are working collaboratively and may begin to function as a coach to the members of the team. Teams with strong performance norms and high cohesiveness are high performing teams. This group can readily slip back into storming stage if not work properly. Next stage is performing. In the performing stage, teams are functioning at a very high level. The focus is on reaching the goal as a group. The team is highly motivated to get the job done. They can make decisions and solve the problems quickly and effectively. When they disagree, the team members can work through it and come to consensus without interrupting the project's progress. If there is need to change in team process, team will come to an agreement on changing processes on their own without reliance on team leader. The team leader will continue to monitor the progress of the team and celebrate milestones with the team members. The team leader also serves as a gateway when decisions need to be reached to higher level within the organization. Even in this stage, there is possibility that team may revert back to another stage. For example, it is possible for team to revert back to storming stage if one of the members starts working independently, or the team could revert back to forming stage if new member joins the team. In the adjourning stage, the project is coming to the end and team members are moving off into different directions. This phase is sometimes known as mourning because members have grown close and feel a loss now that the experience is over. The team leader should ensure that there is time for the team to celebrate the success of the project and capture best practices for future use. It is likely that any group that reaches to stage 4, that is performing, will keep in touch with each other as they have become a very close knit group, and there will be a sadness in separating and moving on to other projects independently. We could use this Tuckman's model to help our team reach the performing stage as quickly as possible. First, we identify the stage of development that our team is at. Then, use the strategies that move our team through the next stage in the team formation process. With focus and hard work, you will quickly have a high-performing team. Thank you, students.